Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. So today I need to look at my power issues, and also why am I carrying so many batteries and so many electric engine units? This needs batteries and electric engine units. You know what? I want to crank these out. So have my batteries, have my engine units, give me more robots. Okay, so what I need to do today is I need to work on the power situation. As you can see, my engines are fully tapped out. Wait a minute. Did I ever hook up that second line of engines? I think I did. I think it's 5 for every 10 engines. And that's no longer in use. That's no good news. Okay. It's 5 for every 10 engines. I've got 20 engines. Yeah, I did put them in. Now, what I could do is I could throw down another 10 engines for another 5 megawatts, or I could start doing solar and accumulators. However, accumulators require batteries. And right now, I'm using batteries to get my robots up and running and for science. So my battery production is not the best right now. Okay, let's see how we're doing on this. We still have a ton of crude barrels in here. Actually, you know what? I'm going to stop this production. Let's see if I can line it up to where... Yeah, why didn't I do this before? That's Factorio. You find little improvements all the time. Okay, so how did I have this? I want this to say connected to the network. If you have less than 200 barrels in the network, not 2,200. You're allowed to make more. There we go. And then I need more power here. But now at least, now they're dumping into this provider chest instead of just completely ignoring it. Okay, how many logistics robots are we up to now? 57, not bad. Power, right. Okay, so let's look at solar panels. Solar panels require steel, electric circuits, and copper plates to make. They'll provide power during the day, but we don't have accumulators to store that power. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little trick that a Roomba used on one of his recent Let's Plays. So let's get solar panels produced. I've got steel and copper right here. All I need is to bring up green circuits. Easy enough to do. Let's see. I need, let's just make 5 of those right away. I should automate those eventually. Yeah, I know. Eventually. Okay, so let's put it right there. And we need green circuits to come up. So, always build backwards. To there. To there. In the meantime, I want... I forgot how to do this. Shift mouse wheel. There we go. And let's just get these going. There we go. Okay, so I need the green circuits to go there. So let's underground belt this to there. Get rid of all of these. And one more. course, I need more underground belts. There we go. Okay, there's the green circuits. Okay, so let's go here, here, down. Let's make this a passive provider chest, like so. You are going to be solar panels. We need our power to come over. Yeah, see those fluctuations? It's probably lasers defending an attack somewhere. Of course, it's the middle of the night right now, so that's not helping. Okay, so this will now start making, and I just want to limit these. Not by what's in the network. Or do I? How many circuits do you need per operation? Well, let's see if it's actually going to slow down. I don't think it is. Yeah, let's actually limit it. Because I don't want to do... I want it to come out of the network. So, if I have a bunch in the network, then I'm not going to worry about it. So, let's set it to 200. But we'll also limit this chest. That way, if I deconstruct things, then it will... It will go into the network and slow this down, but this also acts as a throttle. Okay, so I want massive solar fields somewhere. Where would be a good place for it? Well, first off, let's make a blueprint and throw it in our belt, or in our book. There we go. Okay. And I'm going to need at least... one solar panel for this. There's our worker size, finally. Okay, so that's going to require purple science. That's going to require purple science. We haven't even researched accumulators yet. And see, it's two iron plate and five battery. I'm not keen on that. So let's get laser turret damage two. Yeah, let's get laser turret damage too, because it's only red and green. That'll let our blue science stock up a bit. Okay, so here I have a large, well, not a large, but a respectable amount of area that I'm probably not going to be doing anything with anytime soon. So let's plop down a medium pole. No, medium pole. There we go. No, medium. Hit it right the first time. There we go. And we need our... solar panels. And yes, the worker robots are going to come out and try to finish this, so whatever. Okay. Let's get our... there we go. Get this. We'll call it that. This is not the most efficient design. Eh. Okay, so let's deconstruct that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a whole bunch of solar panels like this. Added benefit is I think I can actually run through these. And let's get the solar panels that I have on me into... yeah, I can actually... let's see. Yeah, I can squeeze through those. So that is something that I wanted to know. Okay. This is just, like I said, this is not the ideal layout, but actually, yeah, let's go for a better layout. There we go. Okay, so we have a medium pole here. And where was that? There we go. How do I do this again? How do I query this? Just right click it. Yeah, query blueprint. Okay. So, let's blueprint this. Good deal. Deconstruct it. And what this lets us do is it lets us get a bit more density. There we go. And I'm just gonna queue up a whole bunch of these. There. Gives us a little more density up in here. Okay. Let's see how our blue science is stacking up over here. It isn't. Why not? We've got plenty of batteries coming up. We don't have the red circuits going across. That's why. And our red circuits... I'm just curious. We now have 60 available logistics robots. So it's not a logistics thing anymore. It's the plastic that is holding us up. And plastic, because of no coal. Right. Even though I'm requesting it, I never put coal into the network. That was silly. Let's get coal into the network now. That's the power line. I don't want to rip that one off. In fact, let's cheat a little. Do I have a filtered on me? Yes, I do. Okay, so let's put a... No. I just realized I don't want to do that. But is this in the network? Yes, it is. Okay. Passive provider chest. There. With... And let's actually limit this to just 4 stacks. Actually, you know what? No. Let's not limit this at all. Give me as much as you can handle. I eventually want this in the network, because I can always get it back out of the network. Just give me as much of that as you can handle. And now each of these should be, if I grab this, yeah, 2 coal. So, yeah. Each logistics robot can now carry 2 items instead of just 1. Okay, more laser turret is good. Trash shots 2. When do I get automatic trash? Oh, it's after this. Okay, well, I'm not going to worry about the auto trash slots yet. Although, you can have the empty barrels. I'm not going to carry those around anymore. You can have that. Can have the solar panel. The brick is fine. Everything looks good right now. Okay, so let's take a look at our... Well, I would look at our power at night. That was silly of me. But if I move it over to 10 minutes, we can now see that the power down here... We got a larger spike of power. So now, what I want to do is I want to go over to... I can make 20 steam engines. So I want another 10 steam engines. But I'm not going to hook them into the... Well, I'm not making any more boilers. I want another blueprint, please and thank you, because I want to use my construction robots a bit more. Where's my blank? There it is. So let's have them, because I know that brick is in the network. So yeah, you guys can lay down more brick for me, please. There we go. Okay. So what I want to do is I'm actually going to take these engines. Where'd they go? Here they are. I'm going to take these engines, and I'm going to put them to the north here. Like this. Where's my... let's just... Right here looks good. 5. My typical gap of 2. Okay. And now what we're going to do in the middle... I don't know the ratios, and I don't feel like looking it up. But what I'm going to do is I am going to... First off... Oops. I didn't need to do that because I get them delivered to me. I'm going to hook these two up. Then... On the... let's go on this side. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make 4 storage tanks. What's missing? Brick. I thought brick was in the network. What the... Brick is not in the network. Good to know. Okay, well, when I get back in the network, I'll take care of that. Okay, so we get the 4 storage tanks, and we put them off to the side here, like this. And then we hook these up, like so. Then we have an underground belt, underground pipe connection up to here. So now what's going to happen... Let me get back down to a power pole. What's going to happen is any time that the power requirements is lower than the maximum of the engines are not going to run at their maximum efficiency. However, the boilers are. Let me undo this. The boilers are going to run at their maximum efficiency. And what that does is if we look at in here, we see... that the temperature of the water coming into here is rising. This is basically going to be a hot water store. So then, overnight, when the... I don't know if a T-junction quite works. Because this is supposed to possibly flow back out, I'm not entirely sure. Because of the fluid dynamics. We'll have to watch that to find out. Okay. So the idea is we store a bunch of hot water in here, and then when it's needed, it flows back out into these engines up here. So let's get these engines hooked up. I might need to make an adjustment on this. So like I said, I've saw it used. I don't know how it actually works. But I figured I'd give it a try and learn. Okay, so, yep. Water's still going up. This is nice that the solar panels are giving us a lot of power. But you see how all the boilers aren't operating. Right, because the two systems are not connected. So what happens if I do connect them? Okay, all the boilers just kicked on. Now let's look at this. Yeah, you notice how the water just shot up to 1,000? And we can see that there's a bunch of water flowing in into the tanks. Okay, so... Here, the... I wish there was a better way that I could test this. We just have to wait for... Let's go up to 10 minutes. So here's the power line for the solar panels. So the solar panels are lowering The water's still going in. Weird. I was hitting the 10 megawatt cap before, and now it's just dropping like crazy. Where do I have three assembly machine ones? Well, let's let this run for a while. We'll see how that works. Oh, assembly machine one right there. Ha ha ha. You, sir, could be a two. Okay. Where's the next assembly machine one? I've got nothing up here. Right? Yep, just tapped out miners. What's... Let's move these down a bit. There we go. And let's hunt down those other assembly machine ones. I'm going to get all of them out of the system. Well, our green circuit production is... Oh, yeah. And I just picked up the copper was running slow. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Shout out if you spot them. Oh, I bet you I know where it is. Those poor robots trying to track me down. Nope, that's blue, that's blue. But I bet you the other, at least one of the other ones is down here. Is that blue? That's assembly machine two. Okay. Always stop for a minute to get all these things back into doing other jobs. There we go. That's enough for now. Okay. Oh, here they are. There's the other two. And I should be able to upgrade. There we go. Okay. Now that I got those taken care of. And power seems to be reasonable at the time being. Basically, what we want to do is we'll put on a 10-minute time frame, and we'll see if the engines ever spike really high. Yeah, because that looks like that's right around the 10 megabit megawatt. So if we see the engine spike over that, we know the water's working. Until then, I'm not going to worry about it. Okay, these are running. These are still working through the backlog of batteries, which is nice. Yeah, so there's a good backlog. Okay, plastics are coming up. Next up, I need a whole bunch of these. And with that, I'm going to make a RoboPort. What are you bringing me? Steel. Okay. And gears. That is so nice having those. Okay, so this RoboPort. In fact, I don't want that on me anymore either. I need this RoboPort over here somewhere. so I can get the brick in the network. And actually, it's sloppy, but I'm just going to put it there for now. So here comes... Oh, those are logistics bots to take the electric engines away. Okay, my iron is slowly tapping out. And here comes the construction robots for the brick. Excellent. Okay. Well, a little more progress. I don't know if this power idea that I have is actually going to work, but we'll see. Oh, looks like a nice spike right there. We'll see if it does. I'll just keep adding more things that require power, and that will have to come next time. So, have fun.